What's going on, you guys? This be your boy, Scattered by Nature TV, and we're here for a brand new episode of Yes for the Mess, y'all. And we are here to talk about a little bit of Kim Burrell, child. That's what we're here to talk about. This woman just, listen. Listen. This woman don't do nothing but open her mouth. If it's not for her to open up her mouth to eat a damn $5 foot long from KFC, she's opening up her mouth to say something very offensive about somebody, some groups of people. Like seriously. Because she's always saying something ridiculous. And there's a lot of people that likes Kim Burrell for her vocals, but they don't like her personality. And there's a podcast that I do frequent on Apple Music. I think it features Claude Kelly and Chuck Harmony. I'm trying to remember what the name of this is. I think the name of it is the State of Black Music podcast, because the last episode that I listened to was the one with Tevin Campbell. And y'all know I love those type of musical podcasts. I know I'm a musical ass person. I love that type of stuff. So shout out to Claude Kelly and Chuck Harmony for that podcast. I love it. I'm subscribed. I love it. But one of the people that was on that podcast with them said, you know, I think that Kim Burrell is talented. I just don't like her. And I'm like, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm like, okay then. So, you know, recently Kim Burrell did a video, because you know she didn't issue that and apologize to the people. You know, she done caught herself in some drama once again. Let me put a picture up here. She done caught herself in some drama once again after some video of hers went viral on different social media platforms, and she kept quiet for a long time, and she done came out and broke her silence and issued an apology and sharing her two cents on the backlash. Now, this is exactly what she did for those of you who may not know. Now, on July the 19th, her video went viral on TikTok, and it was shared by a user that, I ain't gonna say the user's name, however, it was shared by a TikTok user. Now, as of now, the video then got over 150K views, and it didn't take too long for the video to find its way to Twitter, where the people were quick to react. Now, in the video, the gospel singer joked about having to interview people before you decide to make them your friends. So this is what she said: sometimes before we get friends, we have to do an interview. How long you been broke? How many times have you changed your name on your light bill? How many of your bills are in your little cousin's name? Do you live in a trailer, home, or a house? While the people in the crowd seemed to enjoy her conversation, y'all, several people on Twitter had other thoughts, and they were quick to slam her ass. Let's be honest. And honestly, I don't blame them for slamming her. I don't understand people like, I'm going to be honest with y'all. The only few times I've been in the church over the last year is for a funeral. I have not been to church to worship God or to get a sermon or anything like that. It's been years since I've been to church. Number one, I work almost every Sunday, so that's one thing. But if I wasn't working almost every damn Sunday without having to take off, I would not be there. It's people like her that makes me not want to go to church, because they come across so holy and so sanctified and Holy Ghost filled, and they're the main people that sits up and judge people like they got a heaven or a hell to put people in. And she gives me one of those people. I've seen people that look just like her. No shade. People that look just like her, people that act just like her, that be in the church and say that they are doing the Lord's work, but they sitting up here judging people for what they have, what they got, who they like, who they sleep with, all of that other stuff. When people can judge Kim Burrell about a lot of stuff, all she got to do is look in the mirror, and there's a lot of judgment right there in front of her. So it is what it is. So I'm going to keep on going. So after she received the backlash online, Kim Burrell went and broke her silence on Instagram, trying to clear her words, saying that she ain't never meant to offend nobody with what she said. And the singer went on to apologize and stating that she only wants to spread love, laughter, and more importantly, the gift which God has given her in song. And Kim has stated that the false narratives are being created since the video went viral on social media. She ended the post by saying, "I apologize if anyone thought my humor was malicious." Then Kim also made it clear that she would not be tolerating harassment and slander, and her character won't be defamed. Now, this is what the actual post said, and I'm going to read it to y'all. I know y'all don't like for folks to read it. It makes you cringe. It gets on your nerves or something. But I got to read it to y'all, because I didn't screenshot it. But this is what she said. "As a kingdom citizen and a woman of integrity, I can acknowledge that some of my words, even if said in jest, can be offensive. My intention is never to hurt anyone, but to spread love, laughter, and most importantly, the gift which God has given me in song. If anyone was offended, I can sincerely say I apologize. With that being said, the irony in this is that those who are criticizing my statement are displaying the very thing that they have accused me of. However, it's not been humorous or in jest. My image has been used in multiple places and false statements and narratives have been created. The damages for some are quite lofty. Please be mindful of what is written and said about me, especially if it contains untruths. Slander and defamation are not taken lightly, especially if it affects my name, image, and my brand. Those pages where vile comments and false narratives have been created or noted are reported and hopefully silenced. Again, I will apologize if anyone thought my humor was malicious, but I will not under any circumstance tolerate harassment, slander, or for my character to be defamed. Love you all. But this ain't the first time, y'all, that Kim has found herself in trouble. Because back in 2016, she landed herself in hot water because she was talking about homosexuality. And that also went live. And then she spoke to EW about the video saying, I know that people are going to be mad, but she didn't apologize for her comments. She added, to every person that is dealing with the homosexual spirit that has it, I love you because God loves you, but God hates the sin in you and me. Anything that is against the nature of God, I'm called to do what God called me to do, and I do it with passion. The singer did not make another comment regarding the same. And that's pretty much it. All I got to say about Kim Burrell is, you already know that what you're saying is going to be offensive when you say it. You know what I mean? Like, I be feeling like sometimes Kim Burrell be setting her up to be drugged all the time. She sets herself up every time when she don't even have to do it. She sets herself up to get drugged every time. And she don't even have to be going through the shit that she go through. But instead, she does it. And it makes it hard to sympathize with her. It makes it hard for me to listen to anything that she got to say. And it's just like, girl, you are completely offensive. You always offending somebody with your nonsense all the time. You never, you thinking that you're speaking the truth. You're thinking that you're being, you're like humorous, and you're really not being humorous at all. You're being one of those hypocritical Christians that's sitting up here judging people and want to say, oh, it's just a joke because God told me it's a joke. It's in God's will that I make a joke about your living situation or the things that you do in your life. It's in God's will. I got to do what God tells me to do because he told me to judge y'all. Like, girl, bye. You ain't nobody to give no advice to. You ain't nobody to tell nobody what they need to do with their own life and what or whatever. Like, who the fuck do you think you're supposed to be? That's the thing that I don't get about Kim. Kim always sitting up here speaking on everybody and always saying shit about folks and always making these stupid ass statements all the time and then wonders why she get dragged every time. Like, that's the thing that I don't understand. And then you want to sit up here and talk about harassment and things like that won't be tolerated. I'm just saying, like, I'm not saying that I agree with everybody going in on her and doing all this other stuff and maybe harassing, because sometimes when you offend people, they take it to a whole nother extreme and they go to harassing. It goes from, you know, stating their cases or stating their opinions to now they're attacking folks. And that's not what people need. Like, I ain't with all of that stuff. Now, sometimes people do go too far when they be mad and they feel passionate about something. Like I ain't gonna never go that damn far into doing all of that. Now, I'm not doing all of that. But however, she already knew that shit was gonna be offensive when she fucking said it. And that's just period. She, like I said, she ain't no victim. She know exactly what she be doing. She know what she be doing. And I don't understand how she don't realize what she be doing. Like, it's just, girl, it's crazy to me. It's definitely crazy to me. Like, I don't get Kim Burrell. And that's just that. I don't get her at all. So, it is what it is. So, with that being said, y'all, hold on, y'all. Yeah. So with that being said, y'all, this be your boy, Scotty by Nature T. Oops, my bad. I ain't even put it up here. But that's all I really got to say about Kim Burrell, y'all. This be your boy, Scotty by Nature TV. Be sure to like, rate, comment, and subscribe to my channel. And also be sure to share the video and also click on the notification bell so you can be notified when the video drops. Also, if you want to follow me on any form of social media, be sure to follow my Twitter, my IG, and my TikTok. It'll be right down in the description box down below. So with that being said, you guys, your boy Scotty by Nature TV is out of here. And as I'm out of here, I will leave you guys with the promotional video for Nova Cosmetics. I'm out of here, you guys. Until the next one, peace out.